the Lord to increase your faith so that you can do good to the people who are dogmatic, doubtful, and dangerous. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can forgive people who are fickle, fraudulent, and foolish. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can help folk who are haughty, high-minded, hateful, and hellish. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can inspire people who are ignorant, insensitive, and inconsistent. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can love people who are lascivious, lustful, and low down. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can have mercy on people who are mean, mocking, and malicious. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can be nice to people who are nasty, nonchalant, and negative. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can share the good news of Jesus with people who are shifty, stuck up, and self-centered. Ask the Lord to increase your faith so that you can warn those who are wicked that hell is real and that you don't sit back and make the judgment that Jonah did, that these folk ain't worthy enough to be saved by God. So I ain't gonna tell them nothing that ain't for you to determine. It's the same God that forgave you. It's the same God that wants to forgive them. The same God that was patient with you. The same God that gave you time to get your mess together is expecting for you to wait on somebody else to get their stuff together. It's the same God that kept you safe from danger seen and unseen, that's going to keep them safe until they get a word from him. And when they realize that they need to change, some folk will change. That's the reason why you got to ask the Lord for the strength that you need to get your head together so that you can do what you're supposed to do at the time that you're supposed to do it. God ain't gave man one of us the right to be holding no grudges. As a matter of fact, God said, vengeance is mine. Yes, he said, I will repay. If your enemy is hungry, you better go ahead and feed him. If you don't have the strength today, then ask the Lord to increase your faith. If your enemy is thirsty, he said, you better give him something to drink. You better get your head together so that you don't miss your own blessings. Jesus said that even if a man just give a cup of cold water in my name, he will not lose his reward. All I do is mess up my own blessings. All I do is cause myself a great deal of worry and harm, trying to hold something against you that God wants me to let go of. Who are we to determine that you ain't good enough? Who are we to determine that you ain't worthy enough? Who are we to determine what you will and won't do? All we got to do is just get our own self together. If I take time to straighten up my house, then I can help you get your house together. And when I get your house together and I've got my house together, then we start to help everybody else whose house ain't together get their house together, because that's the reason why we're here, and that's the reason why we must be people of faith. That's the reason why we got to keep our hand in God's hand, and don't worry about what folk gonna say, don't worry about what folk gonna think, don't worry about how they gonna react to what we gonna do. Just go ahead and do it, because a soul is at stake. And if you tell them what they need to hear, the Lord said the blood is on your hand. God told his people long time ago, son of man, I have made you a watchman unto the nation. Give them warning from my mouth. If you tell the wicked to turn from his wicked way, and he don't turn, he said, that soul shall die in his sin. But your blood, but his blood is free from your pain. He said, but now if I tell you to tell, and you don't tell,
He gonna die in his iniquity, but his blood I'm gonna require in your hand. Because you knew better. You knew better. And you wouldn't do better. And see, faith is about knowing better and doing better. A person who operates in faith don't even look to get back at you.
Amen.
They just want to help you get yourself together.
Amen.
Right?
That's true.
A whole bunch of us ain't like that yet. It is still the natural, carnal inclination. Whatever you've done to me, I've got to do something the equivalent to you. I want you to hurt like you made me hurt. I want you to feel what I felt when you did it to me. Now that's man's way. That ain't God's way. That ain't God's way, no kind of way. God tells us to love them, to do good to them, and to pray for them. He wants us to let vengeance rest with him. Y'all seeing this? It ain't about me getting my own retribution. Let him talk. Let him lie. You know you didn't do. But they say it you did. Most of all, God knows I didn't do it. As long as God knows, they can't hinder me from what God has for me. Certain circles you go to, brothers and sisters, they don't have the same view of Tillman that you do. They saw Tillman back when, and they had formed their own conclusions based on what they saw. What he was worthy of. That's the reason I never put my faith in the hand or the thought of man. Because what God has for me is for me. And if I would have left it up to what they saw me and to what they thought, I wouldn't be on the narrow lane. Right now, I'm here. Because God willed and purposed it to be so.
Yeah.
I'm just so glad that he did. We're together as a means, as a body and a family of people in God. Because God saw fit to put me back in the ministry. So when John Mark made his decision, Paul felt that way toward him.
Yes, he did.
We ain't gonna fool with him. When it's time to go on that next journey, Paul and Barnabas was arguing and contending with each other.
Yes.
Barnabas said, he's coming.
Yes.
Paul said, no, he ain't. Yes. He left us one time. We ain't gonna take him back on another journey for him to do the same thing again. Before Paul's life was over, he told Timothy, bring John Mark.
Yes,
sir. Bring him here, Timothy. Because he's profitable to me for the ministry.
That's
it. I was wrong about
it. That's it.
I formed my own conclusion based on what he did way back when.
Right.
I now know that he's of use to me. When you come see me, Timothy, bring him with you.
Yes.
I want to make up what I broke up. I want to get things right with Mark before I leave him. Bring him with you. Don't you ever allow nobody to write you off. You just keep your faith and keep trusting in God. Because you never know what God will do for you. If you just do what he wants you to do. Are you here this morning? Family? Some fights? And forgiveness has weakened your faith. You want to move forward, but family ain't letting you move forward. You want to move forward, but you at war with somebody, and you can't move.